welcome you to our Temple of the Arts Shabbat dinner. And we hope that you enjoy as much as we enjoy having this with everyone here. And you know what? Let's start with a song of fellowship and brotherhood. Hine Matovu Manai. Let's all join. Of Fiddler on the Roof. It's called the Sabbath, appropriately the Sabbath Prayer. Shabbat candles. Will all the women please rise to join in this beautiful blessing of the Sabbath candles tonight, in which we ask God to usher in a time of peace and tranquility, a time of rest, but also a time of healing. So please rise, and as these candles will be lit, circle three times to bring the light into our consciousness, the light of knowledge against the darkness of ignorance, the light of healing against the darkness of disease, the light of peace against the darkness of warfare, all of these desires of our hearts in the kindling of the Shabbat candles. Those brave soldiers of the Israel Defense Forces who lost their lives attempting to free the hostages and rid the world of these evil, cruel, barbaric substitutes for human beings known as Hamas, and our hearts go out to their families and loved ones. But right now we're going to join in the chanting of the Kiddush. Everyone should have some wine. Guys, can we pour some wine, please? Oh, that's a great idea. While they're pouring wine, we're going to invite you to join us in singing Shalom Aleichem.
So you have your parts, correct? There is no food tonight, okay? We got that? That's the deal. So here you go. La, here we go. Three, four.
La,
so never, never, never challenge hungry Jews. Very bad thing to do. So let's try it again. Here we go. La, la, la. Shalom, Malachi, Shalom, Malachi, El Yom. Mimelech, Mimelech, Latin, HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Here we go. Shalom, Malachi, Elyon. Mimelech, Malchei HaMlachim, HaKadosh Baruch Hu.
Tonight, before we do the Kiddush, I want to say a thank you to our sponsor tonight for having us here at Brentwood this evening, Harris Cattleman. Harris, thank you. And you're getting the bill, Harris. So we're thrilled that everyone's here tonight. And take your wine and let's join with the with Cantor Lamb in the chanting of the Kiddush. Please join him, everyone.
Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Borei Pri Hagafen.
Amen.
Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Asher Kirshanu Mitzvotam Ratzavanu Shabbat Kodesho Be'Ahava U'Ratzon Hinchilanu Zikaron Maaseh Bereishit Ki Hu Yom Tehillah Lemikrei Kodesh Zeher Litziat Mitzrayim Ki Manu Macharta Yotanu Kidashta Mikol Hanim Meshavat Kochecha Yahava Uberatzon Kin Baltanu Baruch Atah Adonai Mekadeh
join everyone in the Hamotzi, this beautiful challah, which we'll pass around, we'll cut up and pass around, and you've got some smaller challahs at your table. Please join me in the Hamotzi, everyone. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam. Enjoy, everyone, and we'll be joining you in just a few minutes after a wonderful dinner to conclude our prayers and service for this evening for Shabbat.
Carly Bach.
All right.
I,
was great. What a team we have here. What a team. We have the icon of cantors, cantor Nathan Lamb, and we have our fabulous Alicia Pierce, who's going to be celebrating her 25th anniversary with the synagogue. Circle your calendars, March 15th, which is our big gospel service. The Zion Gospel Youth Choir from Compton is coming to our synagogue with Pastor Michael Fisher.
Great guy.
And Michael is amazing. I had lunch with him last week. He was one of the few pastors who condemned Black Lives Matter when they came out pro-Hamas. And he took a lot of heat for it in the African-American community. He's an amazing, amazing, strong supporter of Israel. And he'll be with us that night as well. So circle your calendars, March 15th at our temple's beautiful Saban Theater on the Bima. And we hope you'll be there for that event. Last week, our very gifted music director and composer, Sharon Farber, Grammy Award winner, she lost.
It wasn't last week, it was Tuesday.
Her song was up against who? Lenny Kravitz?
Lenny Kravitz, Olivia Rodrigo, and John Batiste, and Olivia took it.
And Olivia won, but she was in quite an illustrious competition there. And congratulations, Sharon, on a fabulous song. Next time is the charm.
We had a great time on the
record. Next time we won an Academy Award, okay?
Absolutely. That's
all right. We're going to continue our service, and I'm going to ask everyone to rise to praise God's name morning and evening with the words of the Baruch Hu, followed by the Shema. So let's rise and join in this prayer. With our history, with our people, with our belief in one God. Let's join in the Shema.
Shema Yisrael, Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Eloheinu, Baruch Shem Kevod, Shem Kevod, Malchuto.
Repeating with me, Hear, O Israel,
the Lord our God, the Lord is one.
Blessed is God's glorious kingdom,
forever and ever.
Please be seated, everyone. Thank you. And the words that follow the Shema, the declaration of faith, are what we're commanded to do, to love. And you shall love the Lord your God.
Shall be on your heart.
think of them. When
you are at home. When you are away. When you lie down and when you rise up.
Supposed to applaud and shul, but you know, we broke that rule about 35 years ago. So the rabbi keeps trying, but as they say in French, Gornish helfen, it won't help. Anyway, before we do the Mishaberach, the healing prayer, I want to tell you something that Michamocha is next. Well, we may jump ahead and do the Mishaberach. I'll tell you why. I had a meeting recently with a friend of mine, and he introduced me to a woman who represents Bet Halochem. Bet Halochem is the institute in Israel that heals wounded soldiers. Now, many of us know over 250 Israeli soldiers have been killed in Gaza, but you didn't know that over 10,000 have been wounded, of which 4,000 have been wounded severely. This has been a very impactful and costly battle for the state of Israel. And before we recite the healing prayer, the Mishaberach, where we're gonna say a prayer for all of our loved ones who might be ill, or for ourselves if we need the healing, we're also gonna add the soldiers of the Israel Defense Forces. And we need to think about everything we can do as American Jews to support our brothers and sisters in Israel fighting a horrific terrorism that knows no bounds of human decency. And that becomes our obligation as human beings, as Jews, and as those who love Eretz Yisrael to take that position and to speak of it to our friends who come up with these crazy equivalencies or who insist that what's happening in Gaza is of Israel's doing, when we know the provocation was on the part of Hamas. Recently, they interviewed a number of Gazans anonymously speaking because they were afraid to speak out publicly. And they were furious at what Hamas had done to them, how they brought this destruction upon themselves, upon their people. And they said things like, where were all the medical supplies that they should have stocked up and food when they knew what Israel's response was going to be? Where were the tunnels for us? They built tunnels for themselves to hide, but what about for the civilian population? And they did this all anonymously because if they spoke it publicly, they'd be targeted for killing, for assassination. So we have to point these things out to people who don't know better, and especially young people. I heard a statistic last night that 80% of Americans support Israel in its war against Hamas. But of young people ages 18 to 28, only 50% support Israel over Hamas.
That's a frightening statistic. They're getting their news from TikTok and from other sources that are not accurate. So we're not being called upon to go into the Gaza Strip and bear weapons, but we have a very important role to play in educating our fellow Americans and young people in particular about all the facts of what's happening, what's actually happening in Gaza. So right now we're going to offer a prayer of healing for all the soldiers who have been wounded, for all those who've been victimized by terrorism. And we want to add a prayer for any of our loved ones. If you've got a special loved one who may be ill, let's close our eyes and think of them and pray that Hashem, that the Almighty, grants them a healing of body and soul. Dear God, restore to good health all of our dear ones who are ill. Enable them to speedily return to their tasks and their loved ones. As we offer this prayer for them on Shabbat evening, let us say, Amen. Continue with Micha Malcha, the prayer that the Israelites sang upon redemption, the splitting of the Red Sea and the coming through in safety, a song of celebration and deliverance. And there's an important message in that story from the Torah, from the Bible, and it's that in order to get through, you have to banish doubt and uncertainty, and you have to move forward in faith. And that's what the Israelites were not prepared to do, until one man, Nachshon ben Aminadab, walked into the water up to his neck before the waters parted. And he led that example, by example, he led by example of what it takes to banish doubt and uncertainty and move forward in faith. And this is the beautiful prayer, Mi Chamocha, who is like you, O Lord, among the mighty?
Oh,
through a moment of silent meditation and prayer for any meditations in our hearts and minds this Shabbat evening. And let's pause for a moment to think upon and reflect on all the blessings that we enjoy each and every day of each and every week, of each and every month, of each and every year. How blessed we are to live in a great land of freedom. How blessed we are to have our rich Jewish heritage. All the gifts that we enjoy. Let's pause for a moment of Amidah, of silent meditation and prayer. So tonight I'd like to talk a little bit about the Torah reading for this Shabbat, and it's a really instructive one. It's the portion of Terumah.
My bar mitzvah.
It's your bar mitzvah portion, Nate. Amazing. Terumah speaks about the offering that the Israelites would give in the building of the sanctuary. And the Torah says, Kol Isha Asher Yidvenu Libo, every person whose heart made him willing, or made her willing to participate, to give. And people gave anything they had. They wanted to be part of that process. In a very interesting study, we learned that giving creates a response in our health, in our body's system. It releases endorphins that heal us and that protect the heart. So when you give of yourself, you're not just benefiting the person you're giving to, you're benefiting yourself. In fact, the Hebrew word terumah doesn't just mean to give, it means to lift up. And when you lift up by giving someone else, you lift yourself up. And that's the greatest and most powerful lesson of what it means to give openly, without reservation. You know, in Judaism, one of the greatest mitzvot in all of Jewish tradition is to place earth, to bury the dead. You've seen the custom of taking three shovels after someone is buried and placing it. Why is that considered one of the greatest mitzvot? Because you're doing it for someone that you know can never repay the kindness. So you're doing it with no agenda, with no hidden message or expectation. You're doing it to pay respect, honor, love to that person that you're burying, that you're participating in their burial. That's why it's considered one of the greatest. And when we give that way of ourselves out of love, admiration, respect, and a desire to be helpful, we lift ourselves. This Torah portion is a really interesting one because it describes gold. Now, I'm not telling you to go out and buy gold, gold coins, or any other gold content or gold stocks, but I am telling you that the Torah, this week's Torah portion, was very obsessed with gold. Why? Because the Mishkan had to be built and covered, that wandering ark. You remember the movie, The Raiders of the Lost Ark? This is the ark we're talking about in the Torah portion. That beautiful ark with the angels made of gold with their wings spread to each other. Every part of the inner and outer layering of that ark had to be covered in pure gold. And then the other item that was made in pure gold was the menorah, the seven-branch candelabra. Now, Adrian and I were in Rome a few years ago visiting the Vatican. And when we walked into St. Peter's Square, we were shocked. It was a giant poster that said, La Menorah. The menorah. The Vatican had hauled up from deep below the Vatican, St. Peter's, about 100 ancient menorahs that it had in its possession. And of course, we were saying, shouldn't these go back to the communities where they came from? Well, they're part of the Vatican collection, so they weren't going anywhere. They were staying in the possession of the Vatican. But after pleadings by the chief rabbi of Rome, they agreed to exhibit these menorahs. And the menorah is, of course, the most powerful symbol of Judaism. Even though it's made of pure beaten gold, according to the Torah portion, its message is not so much about its quality of construction or the essential element it's made from. It's the instrument of light. And we know that it's the most ancient symbol of Judaism. More than the Star of David, the menorah, the seven-branch candelabra, is our symbol. Why? Because our role and duty as Jews is to be a light unto the nations, or la goyim, a light unto the nations, to bring the light of the teachings of the Torah to humanity. So this week's Torah portion is rich, not just because it's 24 karat gold. It's rich because it gives us a message of giving from the heart without expectation, and also of valuing our mission. And we do have a mission. A lot of people say, oh, the Jewish people don't missionize. No, we did in the second century, by the way. But we don't missionize today. And that's a whole story for another Shabbat. But we do have a mission. And the mission is to be a light to all humanity by bringing the teachings of human decency, respect for human life, to the world. And that, hopefully, is a mission we can all accomplish in our own way. And let's say, amen. All right, we're going to close our service out now with a couple of final songs before dessert. So don't run away if you'd like a nice dessert. It's coming your way. Hashkivenu. Okay, this is a beautiful meditation prayer. Hashkivenu, cause us, O Lord, to lie down in peace and raise us up on the morrow to life. Spread over your tabernacle of peace over us, over Israel, over Jerusalem, Hashkivenu. And this isn't your grandmother's Hashkivenu. This is much more zippy, as you will hear.
This Hashkivenu was actually written by a colleague, Moshe Rothblum, Rabbi Moshe Rothblum, who was the rabbi at Adat Ariel. I started off many, many years ago with the congregation I grew up in. I was the assistant cantor there. He wrote this for me. And then it got updated and magnified and beautified by a fantastic arrangement. I forgot her name. Oh, it was Sharon Farber. And this is her arrangement. And
well, they need to come to the High Holidays to hear it.
Here with the choir and the musicians. But this was her work, and it inspires me every time I sing it because she did a fantastic job. Hashkivenu Adonai Eloheinu Shalom v'ha'amiteinu malkeinu l'chaim ufros aleinu sukkat shalomecha v'takneinu v'etzakov ha'milfanecha
והושיענו למען שמך.
Coming out now, so you can enjoy while we're closing out our service, everyone. We're going to close out with the Aleinu prayer, and then the mourners.
Alicia has a beautiful song.
Oh, Alicia has a song as well. Yes. Fantastic.
You asked for something for Valentine's Day.
Oh, Valentine's Day was last week.
I don't know. You asked for it.
Okay. So we'll do Valentine's Day. My Little Pony Valentine. Is that
yeah,
in Hebrew? No.
Yeah, in Hebrew.
Tenderly, some say love, it is a river.
belated Valentine's Day, in case you didn't get a card or a candy, buy some candies. Aleinu l'shaveach, we acknowledge God as the source of power in the universe, the beauty of creation. Anachnu korim u'mishtachavim, and we bow before that source of power and creative energy in the universe, and pray for the day when God's name will be one and His name one. And we're going to close our service with the mourner's Kaddish prayer. So if you have a loved one you want to remember and recite Kaddish for, you can rise and join me in the Kaddish. Or if you want to recite Kaddish for a soldier, you can do so as well. So repeating with me, Yid Gadal, Yid Gadash, Shemei Rabah, V'Alma, Divra, Chirute, V'Yamlich, Malchute, V'Chaye Chom, U'V'Yomei Chom, U'V'Chaye, Dechol, Bet Yisrael, Bagala, Vizman Koriv, V'Imru, Amen. Yehe, Shemei, Rabah, Mevarach, Le'alam, Ulalmei, Almaya. Magnified and sanctified.
Magnified and sanctified.
Be God's great name.
Be God's great name.
Throughout this world.
Which God governs.
According to His will.
According to His will.
May God's kingdom be established.
May God's kingdom be established.
In our lifetime.
In our lifetime.
And in the life.
Of the house of Israel.
And let us say. Amen.
Amen.
Oseh shalom.
Bimromah.
Hu yaseh shalom.
Shalom.
Aleinu.
V'al
kol Yisrael.
V'imru
amen. May God who creates peace in the heavens above grant peace and comfort to all who mourn,
to all Israel,
to all mankind. And we recited Kaddish for those who passed in the month of February, and their names are listed on our pamphlet. And also we send our loving condolences to member Mal Feinberg's family. Mal passed away last week. His son Greg is on our board of directors, and his wife, his surviving wife, Joyce, was a past president of the synagogue. So we send out our condolences to the Feinberg family. And thank you everyone for being here. We have a closing song.
Sure, we're gonna get everybody involved.
All right.
Jew and a Bessarabian Jew, which means Moldavian. So when I saw the short ribs come out, my entire body, my entire system, everything inside me started to get very excited. And I almost like had this epiphanous moment, like, here it is, we're back in Poland having short ribs. So if you enjoyed the short ribs, on your way out, tell everybody you enjoyed the short ribs. There is a Xanax and a Nexium outside when you're leaving, so don't worry about it. Shabbat shalom to you.